The brothers gonna work it out. The brothers gonna work it out.
Good afternoon and welcome to Kougari Oval on a wet and miserable day in Brisbane, but we've got a Queensland Cup clash that we're looking forward to. Two teams who really need a win. It's Wynnum at home to the Central Queensland Capras, and we've heard some good reports of what the Capras are doing and looking forward to seeing them in action. But let's look firstly though at last weekend's results. And in our television match, Cairns beat East by 30 points to 20. A very close one. Wynnum just going down to West by 2 points. Logan had an impressive win over South. North beat Ipswich by 14 points. Redcliffe winners over the Capras, and Burleigh beat Toowoomba 38 to 20. So it means that we have a table now of Redcliffe and Burleigh sharing the lead on 20, North on 18. Those three teams continue to be going exceptionally well. Then Wests and East make up the top five. Logan just out of it on percentages, as are Toowoomba. And then Cairns on 9, and you can see that the Capras and Wynnum are in a position where they need a win today to be in any way close to being in contention for the semi-finals. David Wright with us. Both these two teams, David, have been struggling as far as form's concerned, and yet, you know, maybe they should be a bit higher up on the ladder.
I think you're dead right, Jerry. It really belies the position on the table, 9th and 10th, and yet both sides have got a feast of representative players in their side. So something's gone wrong in both camps, and really they'll be out to rectify that this afternoon. It's interesting that both these sides played each other earlier in the season, and Wynnum got away with a 4-point victory then. And if you have a look at the Capras' form, they've actually had 3 4-point losses, and you really can't afford that. They're the games you've got to win, and of course, they're on a lowly 6 points. Had they got those other points up, it could have been a different story for the Capras this year. But really, their attack's been excellent, the Capras. They average something like 24 points a game, but their defence lets them down. They're out to over 30 points. So that's where they've really got to concentrate today. You have a look at the conditions here behind me. There won't be too many points scored today. It's pretty muddy, but really, the Capras I've got a good attacking side, must concentrate on defence. Wynnum, well, they're an enigma. I just can't figure them out at all. They've got plenty of ability, but they just haven't measured up at all this year. A winner, whoever's the best mud runner, Jerry.
That's fair enough, because there's plenty of mud there. And Gavin Payne, what about Wynnum? What is it this year?
Yeah, Wynnum, I don't really know the reason for it. They've got a new coach. They've got pretty similar staff to last year. And earlier in the week, they were struck a bit of a blow with suspension to two of their senior players, in Clayton Maher and Danny Grimley. This has been offset slightly by the return of former skipper Jeff Hassan, and there's a bit of light at the end of the tunnel with an improved showing last weekend against Western Suburbs. With an alignment to come next week, from next weekend, when the Auckland Warriors players will be sent over to have a look and help out the Wynnum Club, there certainly is that light shining, and that's about the only light shining today.
Yes, indeed. There you can see the Wynnum team coming out on this very, very wet Kougari Oval. So it's going to be extremely difficult conditions, and a big day for Brad Nan, his 100th game, captaining the Wynnum side, of course, and playing his 100th match. And I'm sure that he'd like to make it a memorable one. There's the lineup. Lance Cronk is at fullback, Alan Glyde and David Siege on the wings, Brett Bowman and Matt Fisher in the centres. Blue Tomatoa has come into the side at 5'8", with Ronnie Troutman back at the halfback role. Ricky Taylor at lock, then Grant Benson and Brad Nairn. Jeff Hassan in the front row with Scott Dunshay and Greg Eagle. And again, that Wynnum lineup looks as though it should be performing a whole lot better, because there certainly are some very handy players in that team. But look at the conditions they're going to have to contend with.
Same for both sides. And here's the visiting team, the Central Capras. Again, somewhat disappointing season, plenty of ability. And if they can show their ability this afternoon, I'm sure they're capable of a victory. They only had 3 wins out of 11 matches, and they'll need to dramatically turn that around. The skipper today, Brad Nevin, will play in the back row. Interesting, he played in the centres for Country a couple of weeks ago. So they've got a pretty talented back row, the Capras. They're very talented around the scrum base as well. Let's have a look at the central side. Jason Allen at fullback. The wingers are Graham Kemp, and Matt Barclay comes off the bench with Clint Rothery dropping back onto the bench today. Scott Minto and Heath Eggleston in the centres. Very good halves in Graham Wright and Byron Hutton. And then a representative Country back row. Well, all these players have played for Country this year. Parada, Nevin and Busby. Up front, Dowie, Allen and Wilkes. The coach is Brad Hopes. They're a talented outfit, but these players will need all their skills this afternoon to play under very, very muddy conditions.
And the referee today is Stewie Burnt. Not only a special day for Stewie, but Raylene Burnt is working for us today. She's doing the stats. Welcome, Raylene. And all the information that you get that comes on the screen, you'll know that'll be coming courtesy of Raylene. And David and I and Gavin, we have to be very careful about what we say about Stewie Burnt. Oh, there's good defence. Moving up very quickly there was Graham Kemp from Central Queensland, pinning Wynnum down just outside their own 10-metre line. And so it's Wynnum bringing the ball out with all the work to do. And at this stage, there's interesting there. Chris Rehberger has come on.
And Mark Lane as well, Jerry. So there's a couple of changes there to the Wynnum run-on side. They brought a couple of players off the bench in these heavy conditions.
And speaking of the conditions, Gavin Payne, you can report on it, but it's pretty obvious, isn't it?
Pretty well documented, Jerry. Very heavy after one earlier game. Although the weather seems to be improving, a few blue breaks in the sky at the moment, and looking forward to a hard slog, the boys are serving.
You need a medal to be down on that sideline this afternoon, Gav. Well done. Look at those conditions. Unfortunately, we've had another game here today, the possibles probables under 17 trial for a Queensland side, so that hasn't helped. Very, very heavy conditions.
And some good handling in that game as well in these conditions. Now, the Capras give us a bit of a look at themselves to see what they have been showing, because as I was saying earlier, Sime Busby leaving the ball behind there, so a mistake coming early. And so that gives an opportunity for the Wynnum Seagulls, and boy, you'd want to be Seagulls out there. And one interesting aspect of today is going to be difficult working out exactly where they are. That's actually the 10-metre line, I think, in Wynnum's territory that they're on at the moment. So they are just in Wynnum's territory.
Yeah, poor play that from the Capras to surrender possession so easily there. A little inside pass that came from Allen gave Wynnum now this chance. Grant Benson gets it up to the halfway line. Take it from me, that is around about the halfway. Brad Nairn goes down the far side. They'll endeavour to play the game on the peripheries. There's no point getting bogged down literally in the middle, although Ronnie Troutman had little option there but to go forward, and gets it up about 35 metres out from the Capras try line. Lane up there to Ricky Taylor. Ricky Taylor's got Cronk and plenty of players chasing as well. They've got four on one here. Quickly across the Capras, but Cronk's just knocked dead, I think, by Allen. Jason Allen, I think, may have just got there in time. Well done by Jason Allen, because he had four players coming in on him there. He was totally outnumbered, and he did well, Gavin, to get across there and save the day. Good kick as well.
Lance Cronk's a real flyer too for the fullback for Wynnum Manly, and looked like he was going to get there, but very good work by Allen to get across and get a hand of that ball and just knock it dead. Well done.
I wouldn't have put too much money on him getting there, actually. So he did show terrific speed, because it really, from this position, looked like the two chasers, Cronk and also, I think, Alan Glyde. But he was able to get there.
Cronk again comes off Ricky Taylor's shoulder. Cronk, we've seen him play on the wing quite often for Wynnum over recent seasons. He's in the custodian role. Lane, straight up the middle, Mark Lane. Ricky Taylor can control possession here, and it's not easy, obviously, in these conditions. You're going to make it pretty difficult for the defenders. Troutman pops the pass up the fence around to Troutman, back on the inside to Fisher. Fisher comes back into traffic, though, and he's taken fairly quickly. Lane receiving quite often. First receiver, Ricky Taylor, fires the pass out to Brad Nairn. He looks, pops it out the back door to Cronk. Out here again, nice play from Wynnum. That's Exton back on the inside. That's Bowman. Bowman searches across, fires the pass up to Rehberger. Out there to Benson. Bit of room to move back on the inside there to Fisher. Stepping through the slush. Good defence, though. Cross comes Scott Minto. Didn't allow him to continue to step.
What good handling by Wynnum then.
Beautiful work. And this is not a bad little grubber kick either, that kept it in the in-goal area in these very heavy conditions, and once again forced the Capras to ground the ball in their in-goal area. That's Graham Kemp. But once again, they're going to have to go through it all.
Well, there you see it once more. That was Ronnie Troutman with the kick into the in-goal area and dived on there. But it means that Central will drop out, a line drop out. But most impressive handling in the difficult conditions there, Gavin.
Yeah, they're throwing the ball around like it's a dry game. It's as in all wet games, kicking's going to be a huge part today, and already Wynnum have come up with two beauties.
Alan Glyde was the man who took it forward. Now Chris Rehberger, a good strong run, or Mark Lane rather. So he's about 15 metres out. Mark Lane playing the ball. Brad Nairn He'd love to score a try in his 100th game, and he's got to within 9 metres or so of the line. Greg Eagle at dummy half. Troutman, beautiful pass back into Rieberger. And he's caught just 5 or 6 metres short. Eagle at dummy half will go by himself. Can he get through? Yeah, oh, almost got it away to Nairn and almost lost the ball. It was good work. Eagle almost slipped that pass away, and had he been able to do so, it would almost certainly have been a try. Troutman with the kick in the in goal. This one's too long.
Pressure there from Simon Busby. Didn't allow Troutman the time to set himself and just drop that kick into the in goal area. And the Capras needed to reverse that cycle. They have done so. They've had to suffer two in-goal plays pretty well. And here's Busby now, the man who raced up on Ronnie Troutman and allowed him no time at all to set himself for a accurate kick into the in-goal. That's Parada. Thought about the offload, and I'm sure his second decision was the correct one. Treacherous conditions out here at Kougari Oval. White. White decides he'll get it down the other end the easy way, and Cronk comes across to pick it up on his 10-metre line. Good chase as well by Hutton. Can he get a hold of Cronk, though? He's got plenty of pace. And finally, the defence comes up to stop his forward progress. Not that there was a great deal of that. That's Exton. He's cut down again. He popped it up the glide as well. This time Benson brings it up the middle. Again, Wynnum will be very careful here through Ricky Taylor. Some very good ball control so far. There's only been one drop ball, as I recall, and that came from what was really a poor pass. So the handling has been excellent in these quagmire conditions in the middle. They use the quagmire conditions with Troutman getting a good kick away and putting a bit of pressure now back onto the Capras. It is really a bit of an arm wrestle so far, Jerry.
Yes, indeed. And as you might expect, too, of course, it's going to be difficult all day to really hold onto that ball. That's their 30-metre line that the Capras have just made it across, obviously in their own territory and with lots of work to do. Scott Minto playing the ball. He's come under the eye of the Parramatta Eels, apparently, and will be getting a trial with them next season. So the association between the Capras and the Eels is really starting to pay dividends. They've already given one. Here goes White. Will he kick it? This is the fifth tackle, so they have to do something with it. Now the kick coming late, but coming from Heath Eggleston. And into the in-goal is going to sit there too, so Tronk has to get it out into the field to play. Good following through there by Eggleston. So he followed his own kick. He grabbed Tronk in the in-goal, and it means that the Capras will get the ball back after a line dropout for the Wynnum Seagulls.
Good effort to trap a player from that distance out. You see a lot of players nowadays doing a little grubber kick from inside 10 metres and then trapping players. But to get a kick away by Eggleston there from around about 35 out and then to trap Lance Cronk in the in-goal, who was hoping it was going to go dead. Interesting to have a look at season points. You can just see the poor season both these sides have had. Wynnum have found it difficult to score points and out of a feast scored against them. And here now the Capras to make a break down the far side. Strong run. Has he scored it? I think he may have done. Yes,
Scott,
he's got
Mindo.
A cross in the corner. Brilliant work there from the Capras. That is an excellent effort using his physical capabilities there. Minto reaches out. Jerry had just said that Minto had Parramatta chasing him. Well, you can see there the determination and the skill to hold off Fisher and in not a great deal of room. You can see he had his eye set on that corner. He realised what he needed to resist the defence of Fisher and did extremely well. There's the goal line dropout.
Yeah, we see it again. And Minto there just pushes off one. Now he has the ball in the left arm and just carrying Fisher with him. And the way he put that ball down right in the corner, brilliantly done. And obviously is... a real talent of the future, Scott Minto.
Yeah, Matty Fisher, who's represented Brisbane previously, is no slouch in defence, but Minto, a big boy, and he used all those physical attributes, his height and his strength, to hold off Fisher. I like the way he just focused on that, well, I was going to say square inch, but you're probably going to say square millimetre these days, in the corner to actually ensure that he got himself down. He couldn't afford to brush the corner post, and he achieved that under very slippery conditions. So a great effort. Now can Graham White add the extras as well? Pretty tidy point score for this season. White hits it, just hooks it to the left hand side, but the Capras have got first points on the board through a very good try by Scott Minto.
very determined run from the big Minto, and that's a feature of the Capras side. They, last season when we saw them and this season earlier, big three quarters. Glide comes up here, just gets brushed aside, and then it's up to Fisher to take the big fella. It goes slightly high, maybe a lower tackle there could have been more successful, but excellent strength and good work by Minto to get to the corner.
Excellent effort there, Gab, when you think that he had his hands on him about 8 metres out from the try line and not with a lot of room to move. So great work from Minto. He's got first points on the board for the Capras.
Yeah, he showed he's prepared to carry the opposition well and truly with him. Here goes Sime Busby, who had a big game in their city country game and was selected in the Queensland residence and then played very well in that residence match and their win over New South Wales in that preliminary to the first State of Origin. Ball being played there by Wilkes. And the Capras making good territory here. They're still 10 short of the halfway, so still in their own territory. Graham White now with the kick. And that ball will hold up and will give Tronk plenty of time to get across it to take it just inside his 20. But a welcoming committee there for him. And moving up very effectively was Brad Nevin, the captain of the Capras, leading from the front in the defensive role. So Wynnum with a lot of work to do. And it's very tough going through the middle there. Brad Nairn made it to their own 30. Still so much work. Mark Lane, referee Shuey Burnt, ensuring that the Capras get back. As Nairn again goes searching but can't find any gap out that way. And that's the fifth tackle now for the Seagulls. Just look at the way that ball. You have to be so careful with the way you pick it up because the last thing you want to do is to come up with a mistake just out from your own line. So Jason Allen there did well. And the Capras once more. But boy, if you're going to go up the middle, you're going to have to do a whole lot of work today. You've really got to try and get away from that muddied area if you possibly can.
You can hear that sloshing there, Jerry. I can certainly hear it in my headphones. And I guess you can hear it at home as well. Sounds like horses galloping through water. But it's not. It's actually these guys doing it tough. Oh, Rieberg has got an elbow.
The Capras and Seagulls gallop.
Rieberg is going to get actually penalised here, but perhaps he was somewhat unfortunate that having copped the flying elbow from Sime Busby, I think it was, he wasn't too quick then to get away from the play the ball area. And it's worth perhaps having a quick look at that. There it is. Bang. Rieberg rolls back and then didn't clear. Didn't really know where he was, and it's allowed the Capras to go straight back on the attack again through Brad Nevin. Allen at dummy half, comes down a blind side, looks up the middle for Parata. He's got the ability to stand, pops it out the back. That's dangerous. Wasn't touched, though. Slow play the ball by Nevin because he's injured. Up there to Hutton. He's dangerous. A little kick over the top, but poor one. Straight to Allen Glide. Well, there's plenty of room in behind there, and the execution was not good. The idea was reasonable. And Cronk now to try and bring it out for the Seagulls. Mark Lane up the middle. Punching defence from the Capras. They do appear to have improved that facet of their game. It's pretty hard to make a break up the middle, especially from your own territory. He's lost the ball out the back. Picked up quickly there by Greg Eagle. The ball was out the back by Benson. Fisher dummy half up there to Ricky Taylor. This is the easy way to make territory today, but you can't get any roll. And a good chase from Wynnum. Finally picked up at the back there by Jason Allen, but there was a good chase by Wynnum. Good dash out here by Barclay. Close to the touchline and can't be pushed into touch, though, by David Siege. Parata up the middle and strong. That's a good roll. And Wynnum have to run back to get into position. That 10 metres is a fair distance if you've got to go backwards. Hutton fires the pass back out through the hands of Busby. That's okay. Picked up quickly. And the Capras trying a little bit of fancy football, even in these conditions, and managing to retain possession. White throws the dummy to Nevin. Pops it up there to Allen. Capras want it on the right. White fires the pass up to Hutton, looks across to see his kickers there. They quickly into position, and Wynnum pick it up through David Siege. And again, the Capras are just keeping the pressure on, Jerry.
Yes, they are. 14 minutes gone, Gavin, and really the standard of play, given the conditions, has been pretty good.
Yeah, it's very high class, high quality. There's not a lot of... well, there's been some ball movement in it, actually. At the moment, Wynnum, of course, will be keeping it pretty close to the chest, just trying to get forward, hopefully with the aid of a penalty, as they try and get up off the ground and out quickly.
Well, Chris Rieberger couldn't believe that they were hanging off him there for a moment, but eventually taking the tackle. So still well in their own territory. Ricky Taylor looking and finding that there's nobody there. So a few panic passes here, almost left behind by David Siege. But he takes the tackle, and boy, it's green grass there. So that's an area where you'd want to be playing the ball, you'd think. Ronnie Troutman with the kick downfield. Allen will have plenty of time to watch this. And he's very careful, ensuring that it goes onto the boot first. And a good run too by Allen. Almost in the clear, but nice tackle in turn as well by Mark Lane. That's the halfway mark that you can see there. As Parada goes for a run, and good driving tackle from Brad Nan.
Celebrating his 100th game, as we said, and leading from the front. Another good tackle by Nan.
On Syme Busby that time. Now, is there a chance out on that short side? Nicely turned back infield there to Craig Allen. He's kept it alive too, as the Capras are now 30 metres out from the line. Can they finish off? They lead by 4 points to nil. Can they score another try? Some movement here. Graham White almost through. Couldn't quite get through. Nevin with the offload. And now there's a chance out wide, but smothered there. Heath Eggleston just couldn't get the pass away.
Good attacking defence there from Bowman and Siege. They made sure that's been touched, so Wynnum will get another chance to use an extra tackle. That's Alan Glyde. It was Eagle who brought it up initially. Now Wynnum, who've been trapped in this part of the field. Mark Lane plays it. Pass up there to the big fellow in Dunshay. Just come off the bench. That's Hassan. That wasn't touched. Play on. Up there to Troutman. Troutman fires the pass up. A good defence from Eggleston. Quickly in to again make the tackle. Both sides have rushed up well when they've had to. And Ricky Taylor says, I like to pick up 40, 50 metres this way. Does get a bit of skid this time, because he did get it to land in the grassy area on the periphery of the field. Hassan misses one. Once again, Jason Allen busts a couple of tackles, showing that he's quite capable of bringing the ball back from that from the kicks downfield. Parada lost it. Wynnum have got the changeover they were looking for. They've had the last 5 minutes trying to bring it out of their own territory, but they've now turned it over. Dunshay in possession. Troutman up there to Nairn. Slips and can't recover quickly enough to offload. This time Hassan fires the pass out there to Exton. Back on the inside to Ricky Taylor. Everyone stopped up there to Troutman. He'll have a bit of a run. Slides over. Cronk, but good defence again from the Capras. You just hold your line there. If they want to be fancy, let them be fancy in front of your line. Ricky Taylor. Ricky Taylor tries to get the line. Brushes through one. Over the top beautifully. Beautiful pass out to David Siege. But did he score that? No. He dived over the Ingalls line. Could you believe it? He missed the corner post, and his dive continued into the touch-in goal. That's incredible, and I don't think anyone was attending him at the time. Let's have a look at it. Siege under a bit of pressure. Yes, it was. The defence there of Eggleston, I think. Well, I think he still got it down.
I think it's a try.
Yes.
I thought for a moment that his left foot might have touched the touchline, but there was the touch judge didn't rule on that.
No, he's got him for touch-in goal, I think. Although, what did he do? He brought it out to the 20-metre line for a tap. So he's called that the attacking side has gone touch-in goal. And the defending side, the Capras have lost it again, but a penalty will go their way.
But that replay, Gavin, certainly indicated a try.
It certainly did, Jerry. It, in fact, looked like he just got a toe on the sideline prior to the in-goal line, but he definitely got the ball down before sliding into the touching goal line.
So an interesting one. Perhaps Wynnum unlucky, trailing by 4 points to nil.
Be worth having another look at that one on half-time. Because there's going to be not many chances today, you'd think, and you really got to take the ones that come your way.
That's for sure. Damien Wilkes. And they've made good ground too, their Capras, and so often when you miss out on a try, you can pay for it in lots of ways. Well, that ball, Brad Nevin, running onto the pass too quickly from Graham White, wasn't ready for it, and just hitting the body, and as a result, they've spilt the ball. So Brett Bowman caught with it now. He's been relatively clean, Brett Bowman. Chance out wide here. A little bit of pace, David Siege, but he can't get away. This is Exton across the halfway and back into the Capras territory. So the Seagulls, can they make amends for missing out on that try? Ronnie Troutman with the offload. But no chance out wide. Brad Nairn, I call them the Seagulls. It's the Seagulls, of course. One's Manly, one's Wynnum. Wynnum Manly. Chance out wide here, though. Heading for the line. Can he get there, Alan Glyde? No, he's still about 5 or 6 metres short. So Matty Fisher gets in to be a dummy half as they spread it wide. Ronnie Troutman. And then further afield, almost. Well, was Ricky Taylor hit late? Or was it just a case of the ball was heading for him? Anyway, the tap quickly taken by Bowman. And they're very close to the line now. He's over. Yes, so Bowman has scored for the Seagulls. And they level the scores at 4-all and they make amends for that try that was disallowed a short time ago.
Rather anticlimactic there. Bowman took the quick tap, which was his right. The defence hadn't been set. After Stewie Byrne had found the Capras up inside the 10. And Bowman low and hard, drives, pushes through the other side. Very hard to get a clean hit on players in these sort of conditions such that you can... really get up and under the ribs and drive them backwards. Used the referee a little bit there as Stewie Burnt crossed the ruck and in good body position, Bowman to search forward and Wynnum have hit back very nicely to get their first points on the board after, as Jerry said, they unfortunately were disallowed a try a couple of minutes ago. Bowman, another player that has played representative football, one of the quite a few of the Wynnum players. And as we said in the opener, disappointment for both sides here that they haven't performed perhaps up to their ability over the whole year. And the Capras, plenty of water to just as much get a drink today as clear the mud away from your eyes and away from your face. And a chance now for Alan Glyde to add the extras.
Difficult conditions for kicking, of course, but he's kicked that one. And so it's Wynnum Manly hitting the lead by 6 points to 4 over the Capras.
This try just came after a little bit of sustained pressure, a couple of good pop arounds and a good break by Glyde down the right-hand side, which resulted in Capras being caught offside. There's Bowman taking the quick tap, just getting his head and body position down low and forcing his way across for a four-pointer. Probably be a bit of the norm, those sort of tries today, rather than the flashy six sets of hands, I'd say.
Yes, indeed. If you get close to the line, is of course the other thing is, given these slippery conditions, you can go to ground well short of the line, and your momentum will carry you over it. Good strong run here as the Seagulls take it up to the halfway mark, and still going. Mark Lane. So there's plenty of enthusiasm in both teams at the moment as Troutman with the offload. And again, right there in the middle, you can see exactly that is just like a pigsty. That's extraordinary conditions, really, and extremely tough. It's Jeff Hassan on the field now. Troutman with the offload. And here's a chance for Ricky Taylor. Straight through a gap. Can he find support? Oh, Fisher's left it behind, and it's been taken instead by Dowie. And he's been able to get it away, too. And so the Central Queensland Capras, through Graham Kemp on that far side, come up with possession.
Well, Capras want to control possession this time. They lost the ball twice leading up to Wynnum's first try, and it was around about this area of the park, so you just cannot afford to surrender possession. You must work your way out of here and kick early rather than later. It's a high risk game today if you're going to play it inside your own territory.
Interestingly, Central Queensland have had 5 completed sets to Wynnum's 3.
Well, they've certainly controlled the ball well. They probably had the majority of possession as well, but a couple of key mistakes. White again knocks it down into the pocket and finds touch nicely. That's the way to do it. He's taken them over 80 metres there, the scrum will pack on that 10-metre line. So the Capras won't get loose head and feed, but now they'll be looking to apply some similar pressure. Graham White, a very talented player, knocks it down toward the corner. All players taking a breather. And Graham White there would be quite happy with that end result. No one in any hurry at all to put the heads in this scrum, because this is hard work, and Ronnie Troutman to feed it. Wynnum similarly will not want to make an error.
It's the sort of day when you get cramps, isn't it?
Oh yes,
very cramp up.
Very leg weary. The young kids who played the preceding game here for the trial for the Queensland under 17 side playing the curtain raiser on Wednesday night, and it's to be hoped that they'll fully recover. And Graham Bricado out there. Graham Bricado, who was a Broncos colt many years ago. He's had a bit of bad luck with injury. Ricky Taylor pops out a magic pass out the back, almost not warranted, but that is Matt Fisher, and that's what he looks like. The headgear ripped off him, and Stewie Burnt not happy with something in the tackle. He's actually calling out Fisher. Well, this will be interesting.
Yeah, I want number four, green. What I saw was your... too much in. I'm going to put it on report, but your arm, your elbow come up over the ball, okay? I know the conditions are wet, but I've got to go aside from that, okay?
Wow, swinging elbow with a man in possession. Worth having another look at it. Fisher there ducks under one, has the headgear ripped off him, and certainly lifted his elbow there into, or his forearm, I would suggest, into White. I didn't think there was a great deal in it, just came up and under there. But now the Capras to bring it forward. Andrew Bell, I've got to be careful here today with Raylene as our statistician. Raylene Burnt, she looked across at me quite sternly there. We don't have a error count on referees, so that's not a problem. That's a good decision by Stewie, though, that one. Scrum the pack and Wynnum to get it out of their own territory. Surely they'll get this ball. Troutman feeds it as they all do. Bowman, the try scorer. White underneath. No chance to make any progress. Benson brings it up to the 40. Take my word for it, it is the 40. Here's Bricardo. Started as a hooker, as I said, Broncos colt, but with some injuries. You can see one knee heavily strapped. I think both knees have been a problem. This fellow, Dunshay, does well to pop it out the back door. That's Eagle. He's finally brought to ground. Troutman looked back to this left-hand side, finds Ricky Taylor. The kick over the top. Chance here now for Seeds. He was offside, so he had to give the 10 metres. Rothery there to pick it up and gets a bit of a red carpet ride because they had to give him 10 metres. And Rothery gets it to about 15 metres out.
And there's so much work for Capras to do. Heath Eggleston caught with the ball. And Syme Busby, oh, set on his back. Good defence. And he's lost the ball too. So here's a great chance now for the Seagulls. Only about 15 metres out. Ronnie Troutman with the offload. Ricky Taylor almost through Taylor. Taking the tackle about 5 metres short. Troutman at dummy half. And here's a big chance. Dunshay back to Troutman. Trying to duck under, but he can't get through. Good defence. Syme Busby made sure that he couldn't get underneath him. Oh, left behind. Knock on by the Seagulls. And just as they were really starting to spread that ball well again, the mistake coming from Mark Lane, couldn't quite pick it up.
Yeah, I think it might have been Bricardo.
Bricardo, yeah.
And you can just see the difficulty the players have got in these conditions. Bricardo was the man who put the big hit on Busby earlier to cause the ball to turn over. But Wynnum now missed that opportunity to convert it into points. Hutton puts it in. Pass out the back to Minto. And the dummy half comes Barclay. On dummy half, little dummy. Not wanting to take any chances, the Capras, and rightly so. Busby up the right-hand side. Bit of a change of direction, but that is the worst spot in the field. You might say thank goodness because it doesn't get much worse than that. Parada again with strong defence from Bricardo and Dunshay over the top, down the blind side. Pass up to White. They've got numbers if they can exploit. Eggleston has dropped it and manages to regain. They took the punt to run it because there was a half a chance.
They can't throw the ball away, mate. A bit of self-discipline on these sort of days goes a long way.
Throwing the ball away in disgust, White, because he certainly thought about kicking and took the decision to run, and Eggleston couldn't handle. Great chance now for the Seagulls.
I think his dummy might have actually fooled Eggleston himself.
Yeah,
Eggleston wasn't quite sure that it was coming to him, and just a little lapse in concentration.
And in these conditions, you can't afford that, any lapse at all. Pass up this time. Ricardo. Ricky Taylor. Cuts across the face, the ruck pops it up to Bowman, but again, well read there by Eggleston, who came from outside in. Forget the slide in that situation. Dunshay, Dunshay pops the pass up to Exton. Exton brushes away from 1-2, gets into open space, but the defence comes from both sides to cut him down. Last tackle, Ricky Taylor down a blind, stacked up blindside, Siege can't cut back on the inside. Good defence it was too. Desperation defence there from Rothery in a one-on-one situation. That was a great tackle from Rothery. And in the changeover on the last tackle, Rothery does well to get it to 15 out.
Yes, he did very well, Clinton Rothery. And what about the impact that Ricky Taylor's having on this game too, Gavin? Especially when Wynnum get down close to their line, he's just so dangerous.
He really comes into his own in those instances. He takes the game by the scruff of the neck and usually takes a running role, especially on those later tackles where the defence is in two minds whether to kick or whether he's going to run at the line.
Heath Eggleston playing the ball on the halfway. Well, they're certainly making use of it, the Capras, but there's nowhere for Andrew Bell to go. Flung on his back there by Grant Benson. So that's the fifth tackle as the Capras will look for the kick maybe. Well, this time just a little kick ahead by Byron Hutton, but that'll be the changeover.
Well, it's interesting tactic to kick short in these conditions and then try and pick up. The little kick got in behind the defence, so I guess it had achieved what it... was set out to do, but Minto couldn't pick up then. Dunshay does well to bump and offload to Exton. Throws a little bit of a dummy and shuffles forward, but the defence pretty quickly in. Eggleston and over the top White.
I was going to say that'd have to be a definition of optimism, wouldn't it? Kicking a rubber kick through and saying, pick that one up.
Yeah. Rehberger now has lost it. Very difficult to handle in these conditions. And the decision by Stewie Burnt that Rehberger was endeavouring to get his hands free to offload. It wasn't stripped from him. And in these conditions, who knows? Very difficult for all concerned. Stewie Burnt's looking nice and clean. It'll be interesting to see whether even the referee takes a tumble in these sort of conditions. I'm sure that'll delight the crowd. Probably won't delight Raylene. She's got to wash the jersey tonight. So far, so good, Raylene. Those boots aren't looking real good.
He can wash them himself, can't he, Ray?
Oh, strong defence. He was falling, but it didn't help him. He caught one in the face for his trouble. Busby, again, the good body position to ensure that he goes forward. Quick play the ball, almost too quick. There's the falling tackle, but a penalty now. Quickly taken. Up the middle goes Allen straight away. White into dummy half. He'll normally pick the right way to go here. Hutton wants it on the right, but he goes back down the left to Busby. Hutton's still set on the right. White breaks away to the left-hand side. Long pass, fires it out there to Minto. Minto into a bit of space. Does well to regain his balance, but finally some strong cover defence. Doesn't allow him the luxury of tiptoeing down the touchline this time. He scored a great try in the first half by doing that. But the cover defence, Gavin, there was excellent.
Yeah, it was a little bit of work coming out from Big Benson there with a bit of help from Glide and pretty much the same area where Minto got in before, but just too much defence there for him in this instance.
Yeah, so Minto again showing that he's quite a skillful player, but terrific defence there from Graham Benson. It's just taking him ball and all. Now Wynnum losing that ball, but dived on by Trevor Exton. And a lot of work to do. Well, that ball has been punched out of the hands.
Play on now.
Yes, it is play on, and here's a chance too. So Clint Rothery, only 5 metres short. Can they finish this off now? If they can, they can hit the lead. Chance through the middle, but the defence holds strong, and Eggleston can't break through it.
One defender on the right-hand side of the goalpost, if they can clear it.
Graham White is the dummy half, so they're going to keep it going to the left. Have they got the numbers? Allen joins in, but they still can't get through. Only about 4 or 5 metres short of the line. Still keeping it alive. Here's a chance for the Capras, but once more, they just can't quite finish it off. So that's three tackles, still a couple to go. Graham White, which direction will he go? Finds the support there of Kerry Parada, and he's tackled, still seven short. Maybe there, almost through. So just so close for the Capras, but they can't quite get across that magic line. Here's a chance back inside on the fifth tackle, but Hutton is caught, can't get rid of the ball.
Great defence that from Wynnum, and I think Chris Rehberger's got to take a lot of credit. He was the man who was caught a couple of moments ago as the second last defender on that right side, but he still got involved in the tackle. Ricky Taylor takes a bit of a chance to offload it, gets it out here to David Seeds, but gee, there was some good defence there. And Rehberger also figured on a second occasion to shut them down. Ricky Taylor heavily involved, as Jerry said, not only at the attack end of the field. Here's Benson. He's also had a strong game. You've really got to be prepared to get in and knuckle down in a game like this. Lane pops the pass up out there to Alan Glyde. He's got man on the outside, but loses the ball. Lane comes through quickly to recover, but the ball had gone forward. And the Capras now with a chance to perhaps get their nose back in front. Loose head and feet they'll have from this scrum.
Well, it's one big grind here. 5 minutes to go to half-time, 6-4 in it. But Gavin, given the importance of this game as well, it's just going to be vital that one of them, you know, really puts in the extra effort to take the points.
Yeah, it's Jerry. Wynnum very defended very well there, as David said. Had a bit of an opportunity down that right-hand side then with a man sneaking on outside Alan Glyde, freshman on the field, Tamatoa. And if Glyde could have controlled the ball and got a turn, they could have been away. Those chances they really have to make the most of.
Good battle going on between Bowman and Eggleston out there in the centres. Bowman up very quickly on Eggleston there just a short time ago. Here goes Sime Busby. Is there any room straight up the middle? He's pretty effective at making room, and he did it effectively that time too. So now nice turn back inside, and it's almost impossible to tell them apart now that the mud is really taking control of them. But the central Capras with a nice offload there. Up the middle goes Busby again. And nice offload to Graham White. He's tackled just 10 metres short, and that's the fifth tackle. So White's generally the kicker. So they're going to try and run the ball. Chance out wide for Minto. Can he get the pass way back inside? Left behind, though, by Brad Nairn. But still, it's picked up by Cronk. And so Wynnum do indeed end up with possession. But good attack again, but the defence of Wynnum has been very impressive
in
this
best
game.
Best I've seen from Wynnum this year in terms of their determination to get in position to make the tackles. There's the freshman in Tamatoa. And up the middle comes Benson, whose work rate has also been high.
And of course, their defensive record is not good.
No, it's been really their Achilles heel. Well, you could say they've had two Achilles heel, their attack and their defence this year.
Apart from that, they've been playing well.
Now, the Capras, very important now, with only 4 minutes up to half-time. Neither side wants to just give a soft try. There's been some hard work done here from both sides. You've got to admire the determination from both. And the last thing you want is a soft try. You really just want to keep grinding it out. Keep the slog going. And not just relax. Don't think it's oranges yet. Parata pops it back on the inside beautifully. Good strong defence too to cover it up. Support play was from Jason Allen. Graham White goes up the middle. There's the gap he was looking for. Back on the inside to Busby. Lives off White, but pulled down beautifully, and some good strong defence, I think, again by Benson. Capras to play it. They come to the right-hand side. Up the middle. Only a couple of metres out, and another last tackle play. The Capras, will they use the kick or will they decide to run it? They'll run it down a blind side. White pops the pass up. Again, I think Minto was the man who was quickly defended, and another man throwing the ball away. It is a frustrating game in these conditions, and Minto realising that for a half a second there, a try was on, and that about sums up the game. Plenty of water bottles to shower down to get the mud out of the face and eyes.
Well, it hasn't got into touch.
Oh, well, here's a chance now with a couple of minutes up to half-time for the Capras to have another throw of the dice.
Yes, indeed. So can they finish it off now? Andrew Bell, the man getting in to be a dummy half. So they've done well up the middle of the ruck, and they've got another chance here. I think that might be Wilts. Now here goes Busby again. No, it's not Busby, but they're only about 10 metres short of the line. That was Parada. So Kerry Parada playing the ball, and they've got options left and right, turning it back inside, and again, here's another chance. And they're just 2 or 3 metres short as Sime Busby will play it once more. Bell with a pass over the top. Oh, beautifully taken over there by Alan Glyde for Wynnum.
He's lost it.
Yes, he has. So they can, they'll have a scrum feed right in the middle of the mud out there, 20 metres out from the line, the Capras. We've got we're into the final minute almost of this first half.
Well read here by Alan Glyde. He was outnumbered. The long pass was looking for, I think, Minto again, but just couldn't find him. Glyde read that well. He was outnumbered 3-1, but all the good work is now gone back to the Capras. This is just tackling practice for Wynnum. Can they continue to hold out for another couple of minutes up to half-time? Eggleston tries to step to get across, but Bowman in there quickly, and Exton to shut him down. Barclay throws the dummy, goes up the middle. He's got a bit of pace too, Barclay, but he's cut down 10 metres out. Dummy half. A little bit of indecision. Parata stands, stops, pushes. But the defence comes in and says, well, you're not going to run at us, we'll come at you. Dummy half. Andrew Bell. Pass up there to Hutton. Hutton, nice ball up there to Busby, I think it is. Bumps out of one. No, it's not Busby, but he's going to be held up, is he? Just held up right on the line. So again, Wynnum have done well. It'll be another loose head and feed. Scrum. Good pass.
Don't kick it away, Rick. Don't, Rick.
I think it's the fullback in Jason Allen. There's the pass onto his chest. Had to jump up to get it. He is a big man. Tries to bump through a couple. Does pretty well. And then the last line of defence there. It was strong work from Mark Lane to make sure he couldn't get the ball to ground. But here comes another onslaught. There's been plenty of defence here from Wynnum. I reckon they've made about the last 20 tackles in these sapping conditions. Can the Capras get points on right up at half-time? Eggleston throws the dummy. Comes back on the outside. Stay away from the touchline. Wanted his winger in place but couldn't find him. Out down the blind side goes Rothery. Rothery steps through a couple. Wynnum have got to hang on. There it is. There's the halftime hitter. Well done by Wynnum Seagulls. The home side have managed to hang on under a onslaught in the last 5 minutes.
Yes, they've done very well, and they'll go to the halftime break leading by just 2 points. Let's check on that score. Currently 8-4 in favour of Wynnum over Central Queensland. And as they traipse off, look at the mud all over these players. It has been tough, but that score actually 6-4. My apologies. So it's 6-4 in favour of Wynnum over the Capras. And we'll be back shortly with the highlights of the first half.
Well, for the condition, not a bad game so far. Only 6 points to 4. And really, Gab, when we have a look at the statistics, there hasn't been a lot of errors. And I think credit to both sides so far.
Yeah, certainly, David. They're going very well in the conditions, as the viewers can see. You know, interesting statistic there. The Capras with the only 4 penalties of the match.
And 7-1 scrum, so they've had a lot of all the set pieces, basically 11-1. So they've had a lot of ball there. Obviously, they've surrendered a bit as well because Wynnum have only had to make marginally more tackles. But they have done well, Wynnum, with the with possession and territory.
Certainly have. Interesting there that possession is quite even. Time in opposition half, well, that's pretty even as well. Not too many much time being spent in the opposition half.
That's right. It's pretty hard to get down there. Have a look at that. No line breaks. No clean line breaks, really, for the game because it's just been so hard. A lot more kicking by Wynnum, which is a pretty fair effort, really, because that's an important part of the game today. You've got to get the ball down the other end. But it was the Capras who put first points on the board. Very good effort by Minto in these conditions. It's often very hard to hold your feet very close to the touchline. But after a goal line dropout, the Capra boys went on the attack straight away, and a good solo effort by Minto.
It was. It was not a very deep dropout, only travelled about 20 metres. Minto brushed aside, Allen glide, and as you said during the call, David, young Fisher got his hands on Minto some 10 or so metres out, and with his leg drive, he kept driving, trying to get him to the corner. Perhaps a lower tackle might have been more effective in those conditions. He probably would have got him to the sideline anyway. But very good effort from Minto. I mean, take nothing away from him. That's a very strong try.
It is a strong try. No wonder the Parramatta Eels are looking at him. Good right-hand fending action, good leg drive, and I really like the way he just focused on that corner to make sure that he could get across. So the Capras are on the board, 4-0. They failed to convert that try, but you can't really blame Graham White for that. But they were on the board. The Seagulls had a couple of opportunities, but really hadn't been able to go on with it. But in these conditions, Gavin, you really got to take every chance that comes your way. And it was, we saw David Siege, of course, just miss out on scoring a try. On replay, it looked like he could have had it awarded.
Yeah, gee, it was a very close thing, you know, David. It was one of those things that you had to be absolutely in the right place, the touch judge and the referee at the right time, to see him get it down. An easy mistake to make, but they should get most of them right.
Here it is here, David Seeds. The actual ruling was that he actually touched the in-goal area because it did go back to a 20-metre tap, but as you can see on that replay, that was a very near thing. The touch judge made his best call. Worth having another look at it just to see how close it was. The touchy is coming from behind. He hasn't got this look. The good, strong defence, I think, was from Eggleston, and he does get the ball down, but the ruling was that he touched the touching goal line first. So that was a good opportunity for Wynnum. It didn't put points on the board for them, but then, of course, another opportunity came their way. They put a bit of concerted attack on. They'd moved the ball out wide. They got a penalty for offside, a bit of an advantage play when Ricky Taylor actually dropped the ball, and then they went on with the job, and good work from Bowman. Took the tap quickly, good body position.
Well, Alan Langer, he got in there, just burrowed his way across, really. Fresh player on the field there, and young Parada, I think it was, couldn't stop him from close range. Referee, a slight obstruction there, but not too bad. Really didn't have any effect on the play. And good try that got Wynnum up to 6-4.
Yeah, they got the conversion from there. They do lead by 6 points to four. It's been a slog in the first half. It won't be any different in the second. Both sides have controlled the ball pretty well. Wynnum have had the better kicking game. It'll be interesting to see if the Capras exploit that a little bit more. I think the side that does that and also gets near the try line. It's going to be close tries. No tries been scored from any more than what? 12 metres out by one guy and probably about 1 metre from the other. So you've got to get up close. You've got to put the pressure on either side. Any chance to win this one? The Capras, I think, if they can kick well, they'll do well in the second half. We'll be back in a moment.
Welcome back to the Kougari quagmire. And dreadful conditions. The rain is bucketing that down now as we await the players to come out for the second half. 6-4 in favour of Wynnum at the halftime break. And well, there you can see just how miserable it is. And there are some very enthusiastic supporters here, that's for sure, coming along and putting up with the conditions, sitting up in the stand, and you really
that's more like it.
Exactly, and that's the place to be, the chook pen. Very popular place here at Wynnum. I suppose there aren't a lot of chooks around today because it's even frightened a few of those away. Good weather for ducks, actually. Let's have a look at some of the other games that are happening in Queensland Cup this weekend and a chance for you to go along and see your local team in action. Cairns playing Wests tonight, and that's a curtain raiser to the Cowboys game against the Sharks, and of course both those teams are feeders into the Cowboys team. North are playing Toowoomba, and that'll be a beauty at Bishop Park tomorrow afternoon at 2 o'clock. At Meakin Park, Logan taking on Burley, and that could be a good one too because Logan have been going pretty well and Burley, of course, on top of the ladder. Redcliffe playing Ipswich at Dolphin Oval at 3 o'clock tomorrow, and at Langlands Park tomorrow afternoon, Easts will be at home to Souths, and Souths struggling in their attempt to really put a win or two together. They have just the one win, of course, this year. And still the rain comes down. Look at that. And there we are. Just the, you might see the blue tent with the worm, the ABC worm. Well, we're in that. We're nice and dry, but poor old Gavin down on the sideline as the rain buckets down. And some of the officials, the Wynnum officials, a glum look, I suppose, but the Wynnum supporters really have to be pleased with the fact that they're in front by two. That's the place to be, out of the rain, and enjoy a little bit of dryness and still get to watch the footy. Now, that's what I call a real fan.
Yeah, you've got to be super keen to get in these conditions. And the first one we saw, the two parents with the young son, you could almost envisage there that they were sitting over under their brolly, that they'd promised their son they were going to bring him to the footy this afternoon. There they are. And once you tell a young fellow that you're going to bring him to the footy, you just got to do it. So credit to them, on Broly, and they're here supporting, well, both teams, perhaps. And the conditions, as we said, about the worst they can get. And just while we've got a moment, a special congratulations here to my co-commentator, Jerry Collins, for the fact that he got an award, the best radio report in Super 12. And that was a national award. And Jerry, congratulations. It's nice to be an illustrious company.
Thanks, Dave. So Stewie Burns ready for the second half. Wynnum leading by just two. And it's going to be a real slog in this second half, you would imagine, because the conditions are just becoming worse. Okay. Look at that rain. So second half underway. And Central Queensland Capras, the first touch of the ball, and there's Minto again, scored the opening try of the game, caught 20 short of the halfway. Sime Busby, he's been very effective in making good ground for the Capras, and he gets them to within 10 of the halfway almost. Options left and right there, and again using their big forwards straight up the centre as the rain continues to tumble down, and they're right bang in the middle of the mud, and they take it into the Seagulls' territory now. So the Capras making good ground early in this half as the kick comes in there. And, well, once again, it's going to go across the touchline. So David Seach just lets it go across the touchline and we'll have a scrum feed. And the central coach is down on the sideline, and that's Brad Hopes, and he is with Gavin Payne.
Yeah, Brad, a nice hard slog in that first half. Any rabbits out of the hat for the second half?
No, it's really from here on in, Gavin. It's not about how many errors you make, it's where you make them, because both sides are going to come up with some mistakes. And just said to my guys, probably the first 20 minutes, they kicked well and they chased and they worked very well, but later on we just got a little bit excited and decided we were going to try and play dry weather football, and it's just very hard to do.
I noticed in that first half the boys trying to get down, coming out of there on elbows and knees. Is that part of the plan?
That's been a big failing of ours all year, Gavin, and we've got to work on that very well. And yeah, you've picked that up. We certainly drilled that pretty hard during the week. And look, it's still just a real tight slog, and there won't be a great deal in it, I don't think. But yeah, if we can get some field position and try and wait for some errors, I'm sure we can do okay.
When you get that field position, I noticed again late in that first half, a lot of changing of angles with Young White and Hutton dropping players underneath. That's obviously very good in these conditions.
Oh, absolutely. Yeah, I mean, they're quality players, those two, and they'll come up with some space to our bigger forwards. And, you know, we've got a little bit of sharpness around the edge, so hopefully those guys can get in, help out and dart and dash a bit and put some people under some pressure. But, yeah, they'll certainly be changing the angle of the attack for sure.
Thanks for talking to us, Brad. All the best for the second half.
Good on you, Gav. Thanks very much.
Brad Hopes with Gavin Payne, and I thought Gavin was out in the rain. It looks like he's found some shelter there, Dave.
Yeah, it's not like the old days, and I'm sure Warren would have been down there in the mud. He would have been mixing it on the sideline.
He doesn't mind doing it.
No.
Sime Busby now. He doesn't mind doing it. Tapping a nice offload to Byron Hutton, who can keep it alive to Graham White. And back inside, the Capras making good ground. Caught with the ball there is Ash Dowie. And they're now just 20 metres out from the line. Into dummy half goes Craig Allen. Keeping it alive now. White with the offload. And straightening up there is Damien Wilkes. So the Capras looking good. That's the fifth tackle, though. But they look like they might run it again. Little grubber kick this time. Oh, they've almost regained possession, but that is the changeover, as you heard Stewie Burns say, with Tomatoa grabbing the ball for the Seagulls.
Also, under a little bit of cover, and with Gavin Payne, is the Wynnum coach, Peter Sinclair.
Yeah, Peter, an improved showing after last week, you were saying before the game, a better showing by the boys as well.
Yeah, the last couple of weeks have been a lot better. We've got a little bit more pressure on our players now, of course, with the Auckland deal coming through, so they know they have to perform, and we're starting to see a lot better performances, yeah.
On a couple of instances in that first half, a little more close support to the runners. People like Dunshay doing very well to get the ball away in these conditions. Could you speak about that?
Yeah, it's just the intensity we've got to start playing at. We realise that that's been our biggest problem, and we're not doing little things like that well. We're just leaving ourselves working one out. And when there's a bit of pressure on you, start to do those things in your game, and that's starting to come through, yeah.
And Taylor and Ian, a couple of senior players, are improving their performance today as well. I've noticed that's gone a long way to helping you.
Nanny's been good all year. He gives us that little bit of spark and defence that we need, and Ricky Taylor in the last 2 weeks is starting to show why he's a representative footballer, which is what we've needed all year.
Mate, any surprises for the second half?
Well, this weather, anything could be a surprise, I think, Pony.
Good on you, Pete. All the best for the second half, mate. Thanks for talking to us.
Thanks, Gav.
Busby now gets it up to the halfway line. Pass up from Hutton to White. White has a looping play by Eggleston out there to Barclay. Barclay fires it back on the inside. That may be White, who's covered a lot of territory to get around and support the outside man. Hutton decides to search back down the blind side up there to White again. White puts a little grubber kick in. He pretty easily covered there from Cronk. But they're in the end of the field they want to be. It's very difficult to work your way out from here as the big man in Hassan struggles through a couple of tackles and just manages to get his foot on the ball. Good refereeing from Stewie Burnt. A little bit of tolerance there is required. And in normal conditions, perhaps he may have been penalised, but he could penalise him for a minor problem there. That's Bowman.
And I think the rain has stepped up again. It's just bucketing down.
This is as bad as it gets. Hassan fires the pass up, hit it back on the inside. Glide does pretty well. The break to a tackle. Got support on the inside as well. There's a good support by Nan. Nan throws a pass. It's play on. Troutman kicks it ahead. Can he regain? He's knocked it forward. Well, there was the best chance from a long way out that we've seen in the game. And the pass from Nan back on the inside just had to find a hand. They had some good backup, and they just couldn't exploit that.
Yeah, there you see the good run by Glide up and the pass back inside. Brad Nan in support, and that pass was loose, but Ronnie Troutman appearing on the scene, maybe he would have been better off diving on it in the first place, but that's with hindsight, of course, kicking it ahead, but then in trying to get down onto the ball, it's very difficult, and any mistake like that, you can't put a black mark against the player's name because it's just so difficult to judge everything and to regather.
I thought Brad Hope's comment was a good one, Jerry, that they're all going to make mistakes today. It's just where you make them. So an error, you know, close to the opponent's try line I guess you can tolerate that, but you can't afford to make them close to your own.
Another interesting comment as they make a break here to Capras. Great chance for Barclay. He's into the clear. He'll look inside for support. There's nobody there. Well, now he throws the pass that was left behind by Todd Lynch, but he was able to regather it, and so they can keep this attacking foray going. White now decides to kick a crossfield. They'll regather here. They'll have six to go. Yes, they have. Chance out wide. If they keep the ball, make the ball do the work, and they'll get a try. Mingo hits the corner post. No try.
Well, what a great surge from the Capras, but even again, some desperate defence from Wynnum. Let's just pick up on the final ruling. Let's hear it. Good play. The pass out here to Kemp. Pass through the hands of Minto. No, it's actually Minto tried to score it himself, and it's gone onto the corner post. So good decision from the touching. And now back to the 20-metre line for Wynnum. They again slog their way out of there. Jeff Hassan. Well, bit of desperate defence. He's been impressed with Barclay. A couple of things he's done. That little dash down the far side there, and then to pass it back on the inside. And 5 minutes ago, he had to chase back quickly to recover a ball in a pool of water. Instead of diving on it, he picked it up on the run. And again, did well for his side. That's Dunshay. Face right in the mud. This time, Tamatoa. There's the last tackle, so you want to get a good clean kick. Troutman gets the kick away, but it won't go too far. Picked up here by Allen. Does well to get his body in front so that even if he did happen to lose it, it would have gone backwards. Shows you just how careful you've got to be in these conditions. Parada. What a work rate he's got, Gavin. Don't mind the physical stuff.
Yeah, he's been very good for the Capras all season, and you would have seen him in the representative game a couple of weeks ago. Plays very well and very consistent in his play as well from week to week, and also in games.
And leading the tackle count too for the Capras.
There he is again, Parada. So that's two out of the six again. Stewie Burns showing a little bit of tolerance in the play of the ball. He said, good enough in these conditions. We want to see football and not the whistle blown. Cronk does well to position himself under that one. You know, you always say you want to take the ball on the full, but in these conditions, it is absolutely mandatory if you get anywhere near it to minimise the risk by taking it on the full. Benson up the middle, a little bit of room to move to. Benson gets between players and allows him to struggle another 5 metres forward. Capras didn't appear to be onside. Ricky Taylor has the ball knocked out of his grasp. Play on. Busby picks it up. Doesn't even think about the offload. And again, the decision, I think, is right. Up the middle comes Allen. That's Jason Allen. He's been impressive from fullback. Dummy half goes Allen. Pass up here, I think, to Eggleston. Down the blind side, Parada again. And
you're never onside, mate.
Well, tolerance has got a limit.
Yeah, Jacko knows.
And
Scott Minto, the man who's penalised.
Penalty going. White's going to take the tap. Very difficult, obviously, to convert from that area of the field. There it is. The number three was called
Brett
out.
Bowman. Yep. So here's a great chance now for the Capras. And can they finish it off? Sime Busby loses the ball forward, picked up by Cronk. And so that golden opportunity for the Capras goes by the board. So Cronk playing the ball. And again, we have to emphasise the fact that the handling conditions are so difficult as Tomatoa just can't get away from some good solid defence. So it's important now for the Capras to try and contain them well down there. Grant Benson caught with the ball. We'll have a look at the handling errors, and really, considering the conditions, 8-6, it's fantastic. They really have done well, both these teams, to handle the ball so well. Greg Eagle caught right bang in the middle of all the mud. And searching out there, no way through. Again, some good defence as the tackle count builds. That's the fourth tackle. And so here's a chance now for the Capras to get possession. Although, if the Seagulls have anything to say about it, they're going to try and keep it alive, but ineffectively. So that was the fifth. My apologies. I was thinking that was the sixth tackle. But now Ronnie Troutman looks like he might kick, or won't he? And he's caught with the ball, but nicely gets rid of it too. And so they keep it alive. Now a chance back inside too. But that was the sixth tackle taken there on Alan Glyde.
Yeah, well, they just needed a bit of backup there. Alan Glyde had done well to run off the pass from Benson, but they ran out of support players, and Capras had done well to have three defenders in behind there There was no chance of even a speculator pass, and another penalty for inside the 10 metres.
I keep calling you, never listen, come on, mate.
It's square on at the marker. So the Capras now with another chance. This time they'll look for touch because they're a bit closer to the touch line. And you can see there it's even difficult to find touch in these conditions. Now the Capras to bring it forward. Andrew Bell, taken by Rehberger. Craig Allen pops the pass up to Busby. Couple of settlers. Busby does well to pop it out the back again. There's White. Looks back on the inside. Finds support. And again, it's gone on the deck. Well, very difficult. You really got to, Ricky Taylor getting a pat on the
just
back
there.
Take
30 seconds, boys.
You really got to avoid leading with the ball-carrying arm in these conditions. And that might sound a little bit detailed, but if you can lead with your free arm, you don't want a hit coming. And there's again washing the mud, not as just washing the mud out of the eyes.
With a muddy arm.
If you then wipe your eye with the muddy arm. That's a front rower for you. Chris Rehberger, you can just see it there, the mud in the ear. That's not bothering him at the moment.
Just wait.
But it wouldn't be the first time you go and have a shower in these conditions after a game, Jerry, and you're in the bar afterwards and someone just pulls a big clot of mud from behind the ear.
Ugh.
Lovely.
And of course, it took that water on the face to work out that it was Chris Rehberger there. It's just extraordinary conditions. Bowman, standing, can't offload, has to take the tackle. And it's just going to be extremely difficult for either side to score now, Gavin, isn't it? 6-4 in favour of Wynnum, but given these conditions, and we can see just making ground at all is almost impossible.
Gee, it's some of the worst conditions I think I've ever seen for a footy game down in Brisbane. It's a case of keep it close to your chest as we make a break here, Eagle.
Yes, Greg Eagle, good run, and he's offloaded straight there to David Ahern, backing up for the Central Queensland Capras.
You could hardly blame him. You wouldn't really pick up one of your teammates in these conditions. You turn around and see a muddied blur.
Here it is, and no doubt he was probably calling for it. There's Ahern in the headband. And he says, I'll take the pass, thanks very much. And, of course, the Capras now with possession. And they've got players out wide too. Good strong run, but nicely taken there by Graham Kemp, taking the pass off Ash Dowie. But, and I thought for sure the defence was right up on him, but the way he took that ball, again, a reflection of the good handling today.
Alan Glyde with a great tackle too. He was under a bit of pressure. Glyde had actually been called out of play inside the 10, but I guess he did hold and... Let's drop back a touch before then searching in. Are they even going to move the scrum to a better part of the ground?
You call that better?
That's very debatable. Pass up here to Tamatoa, big man. He's reasonably fresh too, if that's possible in these conditions. That's Picardo. Eagle goes to dummy half. Finally gets the fight of Ricardo. Dunshay up the middle. Strong work. That's the third. So they're inside the Capras a half. That's a start. Nairn pops the pass up nicely. That's Cronk coming in from the fullback position. That's the number four tackle. Dunshay for his second surge in this set of six. That's good effort from Dunshay. That's the fifth tackle. They'll go down a blind again. Ricky Taylor decides to hoist it. Crossfield. It'll bounce, I think. This could go anywhere. Bounces. Allen's lost it. Play on. I think Troutman might. No, he hasn't. Recovered there at the last moment by the Capras after it had been lost backwards by Jason Allen. I thought Troutman was going to be the first man to the ball. How'd you see it, Gav?
Yeah, they only needed one more chaser. The only chaser here we might see is Troutman. He jolts the ball loose from Allen after it's bounced, and if there's one more Wynnum person there, it's a try.
There it is, the strong defence from Troutman. The ball back in the in-goal area. Troutman tries to get there, but just back in time, the Capras. Seven. But again now, a great chance for the Seagulls to go on the attack. Ricardo straightens it up the middle. Well, this is where there hasn't been a situation in this second half where a side's got really close to the try line. Very hard to hold them out. Benson pops it up to Troutman. Troutman out here to Brad Nairn. Nairn back on the inside. Fires it to Ricky Taylor. The defence coming forward. They're going to drive him back here. Nice work from the Capras. Here's the big fellow, Dunshay. Nice little step too. Puts the pass out to Exton. There to Ricky Taylor. That's the 10-metre line, and that's the fourth tackle. Desperation required. Dunshay, the dummy runner, up to Troutman. Troutman thinks about Benson, decides to go himself, spins out of a couple, but can't get away. Good quick play the ball, that'll make a difference. Picardo, low, hard, bumps one, gets through Busby. Nice work from Graham Picardo. Good body position, took on the defender, I think it was Busby, and that's not easy to bump away from a big man like Busby. But Picardo has got similar good body position. You watch how they get their upper body forward to allow you to bump and then go forward again. Picardo does well. The good quick play the ball made all the difference.
Yes, and Ronnie Troutman was the one who came up with the good quick play the ball. He, you'll see him ducking under tackles himself and got fairly close. Look at the way he gets up quickly, plays it quickly. Picardo has time then and takes on Busby and, well, in the battle of strength, actually knocks Busby out of the way and scores the try. So great try there by Picardo. And we'll see it again. Watch the way Troutman ducks underneath these tackles. He's only short, but he's able to do it effectively. And so he slipped through a couple, and then here it comes, the good quick play the ball, and Picardo on the scene and uses his power to get over underneath the goalposts, and that is a vital try.
It's a long-range try for these conditions. We've had them all scored from very close to the try line. Picardo out of there quickly, the good body position, and Busby couldn't reciprocate by getting down as low and as hard. Picardo had the momentum with him, the forward momentum, and he shows his worth from there to bump away from Busby and then push ahead to score right beside the post.
Vital try too, David.
My word, in these conditions, points are like gold. And even here, we're having difficulty with the ball standing in these conditions. The rain still coming down. And Alan Glyde has a chance to put the Seagulls out to a 12-4 lead. And boy, that will be hard to pull back. Not impossible, because we've still got more than 20 minutes to go. Glyde looking to add the extras and neatly knocks it over. 12-4 in favour of the home side.
Yeah, we spoke with Brad Hopes about elbows and knees during the halftime talk, and maybe young Troutman was listening, because he did elbows and knees, got up, and it was just the momentum that Picardo has there, with Busby not able to come forward off his line to counter that momentum of Picardo's, and straight over the top of him and in for a very important try. Hard to peg back from here, Wynnum.
Very yes, hard to indeed. Peg back. The kick, of course, and the inability to catch it on the full allowed Wynnum to put a bit of pressure on a couple of minutes earlier. And then from there, it's a case that if you can get possession within inside the 10, the chances are you'll get it across. And there's Picardo again. Good directional stability. Dunshay has done his job. That's the halfway line, I think. Yes, it is.
That's Dunshay, I think.
That's Benson. There's Troutman. Troutman tries to duck away from a couple. The Capras realise they've got to keep Wynnum away from the try line. Man, oh, that had to be forward. You can't afford to do that, although it looked pretty impressive. Really didn't time the run, Tamatoa. Running the angle and the timing is everything there. And
it's one here, mate.
Just
don't worry,
forward,
don't worry.
Didn't, well, wasn't much
just
in
forward
it.
If it was.
Wasn't much in it.
Yeah.
And there's Brad Nien.
I mean, the halfway line was so distinctive that it could give you some assistance there, but it really did look as though it was a touch and go.
Always difficult to pick that on that angle out of dummy, out of the base of the scrum. There goes Hutton. Dummy half Kemp. Who's this? Parata again. Tries to spin and bump away. That's the second tackle. There's some more hard work to be done. Lynch, I think that is. Todd Lynch in the pigsty. As against the pig lounge room that's a bit further over. You just see a tinge of green there. So, dummy. Fires it out there to White. Another little dummy. Out there to Eggleston. He fires the pass up. Kick downfield by Allen. And Cronk will have to come across, but it'll go over the dead ball line. So that'll be a grateful 20 metres out to the tap, because you don't want to have to bring it out of your own in-goal area from here. At least from the 20, you've got a chance to get it up to somewhere near the halfway line and get a kick away without error, of course.
Yes, indeed. And once again, just emphasising how good they've been. That's Ricky Taylor with the ball. And, well, he's doing well to stay on his feet, Ricky Taylor. Takes a long while for the Capras to bring him to ground. So it's just tough, hard going, a real slog down there. And the defence moving up very, very effectively too. Eagle, Dunshea is going to take the ball and just take it across the halfway line. So the halfway line is there, right where he was playing the ball. And now spreading it wide, Seagull. See what's out there. Bowman with a nice offload. Exton turns it nicely outside the siege. And they've taken it 15 metres now into the Capras territory. Look at the way that ball stops when it hits the ground. And Jason Allen has nowhere to go because the defence moving out. So Parada, rather.
He did well there, Parada, to get back and cover that kick. After the surge had come down that left wing, it meant that Markley wasn't in a position to cover the kick, and the number 13 in Parada, who's been everywhere this afternoon, was there at the back. Hutton throws the dummy, fires the pass up. It's gone forward, surely. Yes, it has. And we'll come back now. You can't afford errors in your own territory. That's 30 metres out from the try line. And this is really putting pressure on the Capras, Gavin.
Take your time, boys. No ball yet.
Yeah,
it's
really a case of they're 15 or 16 minutes from full time, and the Capras have to do something special. So they might be trying to push a pass in those conditions. David, as an ex-front rower, how did you get on if one of these scrums collapsed? You need a snorkel.
Yeah. It's not pretty, I tell you. Troutman, especially if a winger has run into touch leading up to it. That didn't help at all. Tamatoa plays it up there to Nian. He's had a strong game, driven back in the tackle, pops it out the back, gone a long way out the back. Picked up there by Wynnum, so they've managed to retain possession. I thought it was even touched. Exton's got a hold of it, but no restart of the tackle count. Bricado scored the last try. Doesn't get the luxury this time with Eggleston quickly in to make the tackle. Benson comes forward. He'd be close to topping the hit-ups today, Benson. He's been heavily involved, along with Ricky Taylor and others. Out of dummy half, there goes Eagle. Can't offload, that's the last tackle. They did score on the last tackle previously. Let's see if they run it from here. It's a fair way out there to run it in these conditions. Ricky Taylor gets the hands over the top, fires it up over there, back on the inside glide, kicks it, but gets it straight into one of the defenders. It actually rebounded off the stomach, and therefore not a knock-on. And Minto lost it, but we'll have a play-on situation. Very difficult in these conditions. There's Nevin.
Yes, and Brad Nevin going right back into the middle. Yes, so there's good support there. Just if that ball could have been offloaded by, was it Simon Busby? No, it wasn't. We'll pick it up. I think it might have been Matt Barclay, but Graham White was just on his right looking for opportunities. But they have taken it now into Wynnum's territory. So here's a chance again for the Capras with the pass across field, and Ahern makes a good break. Looking for support, still going Ahern, and I think that's the 20-metre line, and that's the fifth tackle. Graham White is in there, decides to run by himself. That little kick, if they can regather, they'll be able to have six to go, but they can't. Instead, it's dived on by Trevor Exton for Wynnum, and now Lance Cronk starts to take it out once more. Here goes the kick by White. There you can see, knocked down by Wynnum, but Exton was there, ready to dive on, and of course it was a knock back, so that Exton was safe in picking it up. There's Trevor Exton.
And he's knocked it on now, so it will now be an opportunity for the Capras to perhaps get that elusive try. They trail 12-4, about 14 minutes to go in the match. Terrific chance here for them. Only 8 points in it. They can still win this game. Hutton puts it in. Down a blind side comes Minto. Minto scored the first try. Scott Minto to play it. Dumbing play here by Kemp, but really nothing on. They wanted to make more of that.
Again, good defence from Wynnum, and moving up very quickly.
A wasted tackle. Hutton pops the pass back on the inside. Strong defence. Might be Damien Wilkes, I think. And he still bustles his way forward. It's got it in an area where you can actually play football. It is green. Pass up there to Hutton. Up here to White. Back on the inside nicely. Dummying run. Can't get away. Hutton goes to dummy half. He wants to organise something from there. Bit of pushing and shoving in the dummy half. There's to White. White throws the dummy. Fires the pass up. But again, some strong defence from Wynnum. Realising Bowman that they had to shut it down quickly. Tackle was on Rothery. There's White. He'll hoist it into the air and a crossfield kick. Bit of pressure here. Tamatoa up in the air. Beautifully taken there by Blue Tamatoa. The big man went up high. And he actually jumped from the field of play. So it'll be a goal line dropout from here. More pressure coming the Seagulls' way. Good kick this one, Gav.
Yeah, just interesting. We're talking about this rule before the game, David. Yeah, it definitely takes off from in the field of play and then gets bumped back into the end goal. So it's a goal line dropout and the opportunity for Central to get back into this. A poor kick too.
Just goes the mandatory 10 metres. Dived on quickly. The Capras with a good chance to get another try on the board. Dummy half run. Finally pulled down. It might have been Nevin. Yes, it was. Dummy half there, Dowie. Pops the pass up there to Allen. That's Jason Allen. Craig Allen, a dummy half. Pass up there to White. White can contrive something. Back on the inside. Strong defence too. Bumping run there, I think, by Wilkes. Good quick play the ball. Out of dummy half goes Allen. Allen's across. Another try from close range. Diving, dodging in close there. Very difficult for the defenders to do much about it. You've got to be wall to wall. And have a look at the conditions here. And the young fellow in Craig Allen gets out of dummy half quickly. Again from a good quick play the ball.
Yes, he did. And so that's exactly what the Capras needed to get back into this game. And it reduces the margin to 4 points. And there you see that good bumping run by Wilkes. He gets very close to the line. And then Craig Allen into dummy half. I think he couldn't believe his eyes because he looked to the left. And then when he looked to the right, there was just half a gap. And he headed straight through.
Jerry, worth having a look what Gavin has been talking about here about elbows and knees. Well, just have a look what happens here back on the inside. Is the original pass up to Wilkes. Look at that. Sees elbows and knees. Allows you to get up quickly to play the ball. Out of dummy half. There goes Craig Allen. That's why the try was scored. The defence had not reset. There it is. Good quick play the ball. If you get elbows and knees, rather than being pushed onto your back or on your side or in an awkward position, it'll guarantee a good quick play the ball. And that is so important. And they finally got what they were looking for. Possession. Not just possession at the moment, but possession near the try line from a forced goal line dropout that went a mere 11 metres. Graham White to bring it back to 2 points. Just got it over the bar. And now we've got a ball game. Only 2 points in it in favour of the Seagulls.
Good sustained pressure from the Capras there. They had the set of six, had their shot at them, popped back and got that goal line dropout. Got another set. There's Big Wilkes taking it forward. And you see here, Nean just trying to get up from that missed tackle, just getting back to the goal line, turning as the young hooker Allen takes off, and again they weren't able to come forward and stop that forward momentum from the Capras. Young Allen gets over for a very important try, and yeah, we've got a game on our hands again now.
Yes indeed. So about 11 minutes to go in the match, and it could go either way. It looked like Wynnum had done enough to get themselves a handy break as Minto takes the ball from the kickoff, and now the Capras, they'll be inspired by that. But it's not going to be easy. Just to score. Whoever scores the next try might well be able to clinch the game. Brad Nevin has led very well this Capras lineup. He's done a lot of work.
Jerry, three of the four tries have come straight from goal line dropouts. And even the fourth one has come from a penalty for an offside. And then immediately after that, they scored. So it just shows you, you've got to get field position in these conditions. And when you do, you're very hard to hold out from close to the try line.
And of course, that goal line dropout coming after Blue Tomatoa jumping from the field of play into the in-goal areas. That kick is too long, so they won't get a goal line dropout there. Instead, Wynnum will bring it back to the 20 metre for the tap.
Just shows you the difficulty here, Jerry, of a kicker when he's thinking this one might land and stop. He doesn't know where it's going to skid on.
Yeah.
And Graham White there put the kick in, thinking that it might just hit a muddy patch. It didn't. It hit a grassy patch and skidded on, so he didn't get what he was after. And that was to trap the Seagulls in their own in goal or deep inside their own territory.
Trevor Exton playing the ball, and of course there aren't too many green patches at all left on this ground. Going over the top, Jeff Hassan. And, well, it's so difficult to even work your way through running forward. They're up almost to the halfway, though, now, Wynnum. So, well, Eagle, in the end, ran by himself, and that was the fifth tackle. But he did take it into the Capras territory. But they're almost standing here. Ricky Taylor will take the kick, a wobbly old one, but it will stay alive. And, again, there's not a lot of room there for Clinton Rothery. So he's caught about 25 metres out from his own line. There goes Jason Allen across field, looking to make some ground up the middle, and nicely offloaded too. So what can they do? That's caught with the ball as Clinton Rothery now. And they've lost the ball. Yeah, so the Seagulls come up with possession.
Well, disappointment now for the Capras. They weren't back to 10 metres there either. They were just absolutely shocked that they lost ball that close. And now a great chance for the Seagulls to reverse the trend that we've had in this game in recent times. Mark Lane gets it up to the 20. Must move up here. It's very difficult for the defending side, but you just got to get up. There's Hassan. Knocked down. That's a one-on-one play on, though. Ricky Taylor gets a hold of it. That should be six to go. Ricky Taylor's got it. Yes, it is. Six to go. All they got to do is grind it toward the try line. Grind is probably not the right word. Just slog it away. Dunshay, good, quick moving defence. He's lost it. Good defence that was. Dunshay complaining that there was two in the tackle. Capras now to work it away. The Capras will get a penalty out of this for not standing square on. Very difficult for players to obey the rules today because it's just so hard to get the feet moving back into position. Down the blind side. Oh, high tackle, Ricky Taylor. Well, it was he released from that. He certainly didn't go on with it.
Come over here, thanks.
He had his hand up and basically he ran through the tackle. He certainly didn't have a great deal of forward impact.
I'm going to put on report, Rick, and let's leave it at that. Okay.
Very difficult in these conditions, as we said. It's on report, and that's, I think, good refereeing. Brad Nevin, the skipper, in a bit of trouble too. But it's not the head injury, it's more a wrist. And I guess we could be thankful that other players haven't incurred unfortunate injuries from these slippery conditions. Up the middle, Minto. Quick play, the ball's required. The Capras must win today if they're going to stay alive. They'll still need a miracle. They've only won three out of 11. There's a miracle pass. Back out there to Wilkes. He wants a quick play, the ball. The elbows and knees again in the mud and the slush. Couldn't, got out of there. Picked up quickly there. Ahern. Ahern gets it to midfield. And that looks about 25 metres out. Hutton back on the inside to Jason Allen. Bit of a gap there too. Fires a long pass over the top. Picked up by Graham White. Nice pass up there to Parada. Parada goes straight through. Good chance to score in slippery conditions. But pulled down there by Cronk and a good tackle. Good quick play the ball too. Pops it up. There should be extras out there. They didn't get the forward momentum. And just held up. Ricky Taylor's stolen it. Well, he's stolen the ball, I thought. Held up will be the ruling. No, it was actually Bowman who stole. Worth having another quick look.
Well, there's several players in the tackle.
Bowman. He's called held up, so he hasn't called stolen ball here. He's called held up over the line. Although it's debatable, so it will be loose head and feet to the Capras. They still get a chance to win this game with about 7 minutes up to full time. Down the blind side, Parada. Ahern to dummy half. Difficult conditions up the middle. I think that's Wilkes. Well, I could be. No, it is Wilkes. Allen. Pass up here to Hutton. Out to White. What can he contrive? Baseball out into Minto. One on one. Back on the inside. Been knocked on by Seagulls. Back on. Six to go. Allen. Jason Allen. Go. Go hard. Go low. He doesn't get far enough. 1 metre short. Desperate to win this game, the Capras, and just as desperate to hold them out. Winds have been like gold for both these sides. Pass up there to Hutton, back on the inside, standing start. Parada couldn't get a move on, although it could be Dowie.
Yeah, it's Dowie there.
And Dowie up to play it. Pass up here now to Hutton, back on the inside, goes to Nome, picked up beautifully on the run, but again the defence of Wynnum has been outstanding. Can they hold out for a little bit longer? Parada tries the stepping run. The pass wasn't a good one. Minto's calling for it on this left-hand side. Still be ambitious. They go right anyway. Go low and hard, but again short. Nice work from the Seagulls. Benson in there to make the tackle. Very difficult to get wide now from here. Hutton goes for the in-goal area. Chips over the top. Cronk's there. We'll have to play it. Hello, hello. Another goal line dropout. Three of the four tries have been directly from goal line dropouts. Could it be another one?
Well, indeed, here goes the kick into the in-goal area, and this time again you have to hope and pray. A little bit of interference there after the kick, but it's a matter of hoping and praying that the heavy conditions will hold the ball up, and that's exactly what happened there. And so that Lance Cronk had to, in self-defence, just thump the ball out, and now they'll have another go, the Capras. So can they do it this time? Jason Allen looking for a way through the middle, and it's been good defence from the Seagulls, and they'll want to keep it going. Here goes Parada again. He's big, he's strong and powerful. It's Wilkes Damien Wilkes. Now, a chance in the middle, but they still can't get through. So Craig Allen is caught just short. White now, he's got players outside him across to Hutton. Hutton turns it beautifully back inside, but again the defence is there, and Ricky Taylor coming up with a vital tackle on Andrew Bell. To the left there's no room for White to get rid of the ball, and that's the fifth tackle. So again they've run short of time. Andrew Bell sends it into Hutton. Here's a kick for the wing on the far side. This will be an interesting battle.
Offside is called. No, he hasn't. Sorry, Jerry. It's gone dead, so it'll be a 20-metre tap. The pressure off now. Nice work from Wynnum. That's some great defence there. The one you called by Ricky Taylor was a special. The one-on-ones have got to be made. There's the crossfield kick. I thought he'd called offside, but it didn't matter because, well, Wynnum looked like they tried to put that dead.
Brad Mann looked like he put his hands up, yeah, as if he were actually helping it on its way, but... apparently he didn't, but from our camera angle you thought it looked as though he might well have helped it.
Very difficult for everybody concerned today, including referees, to pick up the close ones.
Well, we're down now to only about 3.5 minutes to go. 12-10 in favour of Wynnum, so just 2 points in it. And as David was pointing out, such a vital game for both these two teams. They've really got to win. There goes Ricky Allen, can't find any way through. They're just dogged defence, Ricky Taylor I should say. And, well, he's taking his time getting up. Looks like he might have been hurt in that. And they'd all be feeling it right now. Chris Rehberger buried in the middle of the mud, five short of the halfway on the fifth tackle. So we'll see the kick from Ronnie Troutman. And plenty of time for Jason Allen. Well, the ball just stopping dead exactly where it was. And Clint Rothery coming up with it. So the Capras trailing by two and knowing that the clock is ticking down. And they've really got to get right up to the other end of the field as quickly as possible. And that's the halfway mark that they've crossed now through Craig Allen. White, oh, bit of a juggle there, but they keep it alive. And Hutton searches back inside, finds White again. White putting the ball to ground, but now they keep it alive as Eggleston goes on a run out wide and gets a nice pass away to Rothery. Into the open he goes, still alive. Oh, great tackle by Ronnie Troutman in cover.
Oh, he's hurt himself too, Troutman. Or could be just cramps.
Cramps, I think.
And, Jerry, you predicted this in these conditions that players were going to suffer. But Troutman put his body on the line there. This tackle had to be made. The step back on the inside by Rothery, and then Troutman coming across, bundles him in to touch the ball. Just then goes into touch off the foot, and Wynnum will get loose head and feed with a chance to work their way out.
David, hasn't there been some good one-on-one last-ditch defence? Ricky Taylor in a couple of instances there previously, right down on that goal line when they had the two sets. A couple of brilliant tackles, and Troutman there. Wynnum are really desperate to win this game. I'm just wondering if they had that desperation earlier in the season from their position on the ladder.
I doubt it, Gav. They've only won 2 out of 11 coming into this game, and they would have been one of the sides more fancied for the competition this year.
Well, they did make the pre-season final, didn't they?
They did too, and a lot was expected of them. But as you mentioned, concentration and commitment. Talent's one thing, but unless you're ready to play, it really doesn't add up. The big fellow in Tamatoa.
An interesting comment by Peter Sinclair that the Auckland players will be coming here next week and there's going to be pressure now on these players. His thought was that they've lifted their game because they know that they might lose their position in the top team.
Yeah, and he also inferred, Jerry, I think that it's unfortunate that perhaps that's a double tackle. He inferred, I thought, that it's unfortunate that they needed that incentive perhaps to lift themselves because it's perhaps all too late. For Wynnum, there's the second man in the tackle, stripping the ball from Rehberger. But they'll enjoy this win today, Wynnum. They've earned it. Although at 12-10 with only about a minute or so to go, both sides have really slugged it out. This fella's had a terrific game, Brad Nairn, in his 100th game for the club as well, has led by example. And, well, they all should get a winning bonus out of this, I think, because this is really... This is the extreme of conditions. Not a dummy half. No, the pass up there to Ricky Taylor. He's had a terrific game as well. Brings it forward. They're just going slow now to wind the clock down. Rehberger, another slow play. Just to go forward. Super security, two hands on the ball. You can see him there hugging it to his chest.
And working his way forward, and that just takes up more time as well.
Tamatoa, the big fellow, goes forward, surges well. It's been a nice steady set of six for the Seagulls. Last tackle up to Ricky Taylor. Oh, he tried to hoist it. Poor kick. Could anything could happen here? Bowman, he's offside. Well, the Capras will get another chance. And if they find touch from here, they'll time off. There's the hooter. So
I was just going to say, if they score from here, it'll be a brilliant try in the conditions, but they can, might not get that chance.
They can find touch and go again. And White does that. So here's the last play of the game. One last throw of the dice for the Capras in impossible conditions. Well, what's on? The kick. White's going to take the tap. That would suggest a kick. And up she goes. Well, you might as well just give it to him. If you're going to put it up, you had to put it up so your chasers could get to it. And Cook will pick it up. Put two hands on the ball, son, and just go to ground.
Well, and go to ground he does.
Go to water, go to mud. He's done it.
Yes, he has, and Wynnum have come up victors after a slog-a-thon in very, very difficult conditions. But given the conditions, they've come up with some pretty good football, both teams. And as David said, maybe they both deserve winning bonuses there. But Wynnum, the victors by 12 points to 10. And, goal-kicking in the end was the difference. But, boy, oh, boy, wasn't that a tough day today. Really had to work hard to get any opportunity to score. And there, that picture tells the story, doesn't it? Just how tough it has been. They'll be really enjoying the shower once they come off after that terrific battle. Dunshay there, congratulating a few of his fellow players. Trevor Exton, some of the stats from the game. The full-time statistics there, the penalties favouring the Capras 9-1. The scrums favouring them as well. The errors their way only by one, though. The tackles are fairly even. Metres gained, the Capras a little bit more. But, of course, they trailed on the scoreboard itself by just the 2 points. And time in possession fairly similar, as is time in the opposite half. Completed sets, the Capras coming up with 16 and the Seagulls 11. The line breaks, well, it's not a day for line breaks, really. And as a result, there was plenty of kicking. And even that was fairly even as well. So not much between the two teams. Unfortunately, from the Capras' point of view, only one team can come up with the victory and the vital 2 points. And those 2 points for Wynnum will keep alive their chances, slim as they may be. We can go down to the man of the match, Brad Nan, and he's with Gavin Payne.
And, mate, couldn't have got worse conditions in which to play it.
Yeah, mate, yeah, we've got the result we wanted. We had a lot of tough weeks in the last month or two, and starting to put it together now.
Mate, played with plenty of spirit there in the game today. All the boys dug in deep, yourself included. You know, Ricky Taylor, Big Dunshay had a good game also. You found something extra today?
Yeah, mate, yeah. We knew it was going to be tight and we just had to hit it up the middle. That's what we did, and we controlled the ball to a certain extent, and we got away with it.
Controlled it well enough to get away with a good win, mate. Yeah, mate, yeah. Listen, congratulations on the 100th game. Any plans to carry on from here and scare those teams in front of you?
Mate, yeah, we hope to. Like, it was a good effort last week. We've built on this week and we've just got a couple of tough weeks ahead, and I think we can go forward.
All the best for the rest of the season, Brad. Congratulations.
Yeah, thanks, mate.
Yes, Brad Nan. He played very well in those extremely difficult conditions. And now down on the sideline, Peter Sinclair. Well, before we go to him, we've got the scoring summary there. You can see that Bowman and Bricado coming up with the tries, and Alan Glyde was the difference, 2 from 2. Minto and Wilkes scoring. White, 1 from 2. So victory to Wynnum by 12 points to 10 over the Central Capras. And next week, hopefully the weather will improve and we'll have Wests against Easts at Purtell Park. Join us then.